Okay, great.
Hear you.
Hi, I'm Dr. Sharifa Nadia. I'm the postgraduate chairperson. With me today is Mr. Edmund Ngo and also Puan Azlina. So I will start the session with a little bit of briefing about what postgraduate programs that the School of Communication offer. Okay, well, USM is actually the first university in Malaysia to offer communication studies in 1971. Arts program in communication is actually the 13th best in Asia by EdUniversal Best Masters ranking. Yeah, okay. So we currently have one program by coursework, which is Master of Communication in IMC. One mixed mode program, Master of Arts in Communication, and also two research programs, Master of Arts in Communication and also Doctor of Philosophy in Communication, which I will explain in detail later, one by one. Okay, so this is the Master of Communication for Integrated Marketing Communication. This is by coursework, yeah. So for this program, the students will learn about the principles to integrate various communication functions such as public relations, advertising, and also promotions in order to develop consumer-centric marketing communication solutions. So this program will have some admission requirement, which is a relevant first degree from a recognized university with CGPA of 2.75 and above. But if you don't achieve 2.75, you might be considered if you have experience in the field of marketing or communication for at least 1 year. Okay, and you also have to have a minimum score of 35 for TOEFL for English, minimum band of band 5 for IELTS, minimum score of 36 for PTE, or minimum score of 154 for CEE or CPE. For English, you might be exempted to get all these examinations if English is the candidate mother tongue of your university, or if you graduate from an institution of higher learning in which the medium of instruction in bachelor or in master degree is in English. Okay, so these are the list of courses that you will have to take. It encompasses of 43 units of coursework, okay, which most of them are core subjects, but there's elective in two subjects where you can choose either you want to do issues in IMC or digital strategies in IMC. Okay, so each of these subjects encompass of three units. And by the end of your studies, you'll have to do a IMC research project, which encompasses of 10 units. Okay. And then the program intake is for twice a year in February and September, but the application can be made throughout the year. Okay, so you may do the program full-time or part-time. The full-time is minimum by 3 semesters and maximum is 4 semesters. And for part-time, the minimum is 4 semesters and maximum is 8 semesters. By the way, I didn't mention it before, this course will be conducted in our branch in Kuala Lumpur, USM in Kuala Lumpur. Okay. So this... Next, okay, the next program that I'm going to share with you is the Master of Arts in Communication, but this one is by mixed mode, where you have to conduct a research and take 3 courses, okay, whereby the 70% of the of the program is evaluated by your research, and 30% of the program is evaluated by the courses that you take. Okay. So the admission requirement is the same as the one that I explained before. Okay, you still have to get 2.75 for CGPA and above, but if you don't and you have some experience, for at least 1 year, then you might want to apply as well. Okay. Okay, for the course structure, the students are required to complete 40 units, whereby the 40 units comprises of three core courses, okay, which we have listed down here: the advanced communication theory, quantitative communication research methods, and also qualitative communication research methods. So each of these courses encompass of 12 units, whereby your dissertation, your thesis, they encompass of 28 units of the whole 40 units for the program. Okay, so you have to conduct one research under the supervision of an academic staff, right? Okay, so the intake for that program is also in February and September. The application for February and September intake starts in October and April respectively. So if you want to apply for the February intake, you have to start applying, okay, in October. So if you want to apply for the September intake, start applying in April. Yeah. So the program duration minimum is 3 semesters, which is 1.5 years for full-time, and maximum is 6 semesters, which is 3 years for full-time students. But if you want to do it part-time, the minimum is 4 semesters, which is 2 years, and the maximum is 8 semesters. Okay. The fee structure is as following, as you can see here. Okay. Okay, the next one is the programs that we offer by research mode. Okay, we have two programs that we offer by research mode. The first one is Master of Arts in Communication, and also the Doctoral of Philosophy, the PhD. Okay, so for this category, you'll just have to conduct a research with the supervision by one or two academic staff in the school. Okay, so the criteria for admission is as following. It's still the same. For the CGPA, must be 2.75 and above. Okay, so but in order for you to apply for these courses, for these programs, you have to produce, or you have to submit your proposal. All right, for a Master of Arts, the minimum CGPA is 2.75, but for the PhD is a little bit different, which we will see later. Okay, okay, for the PhD, your master degree must be 3.0 or above. Okay, or you can also apply with your bachelor degree if it is the first class, okay, 3.67 and above. Okay, so the rest, the requirement for the Doctoral of Philosophy is also the same as Master of Arts in Communication. Okay, the fee structure is as following. Okay, so the you can see here. Okay, it's all in USD. Okay, okay, for Master of Arts, the full time is minimum is 2 semesters, it's 1 year. Okay, maximum is 6 semesters, which is 3 years, but that is by full time, right? And then for your part time, for Master of Arts, is minimum is 4 semesters, which is 2 years, and maximum 12 semesters. Okay. For your Doctoral of Philosophy, minimum is 4 semesters, which is 2 years, okay, by full time. Maximum 10 semesters, while by part-time is minimum is 6 semesters and maximum is 15 semesters. Okay. All right, so I think that's just a brief explanation about all the programs that we have. So if you have some questions, you can share it here. And I also have Mr. Edmund as well. Thank you.
Hello.
如果你们有一些疑问，可以问。OK，要到你了是吧？
Sorry。可以，你可以打电话。可以，没问题。Oh my god！ Rise up。 Please mute semua microphone first, then let those who would like to apply to ask question, then they unmute your mic directly. All right, for those who like to ask question, please unmute your microphone.
Hello, can I ask a question?
Yes,
please.
Look, can I speak in Chinese? 我可以说中文吗?
可以，我想问一下，你们有跨文化传播这个专业吗？
Intercultural.
Intercultural
communication. Yeah.
我们暂时是没有这一个program 的。
有文化研究。
文化研究啊，有没有这个专业？就是类似这种。等一下啊。或者我想了解你们的这个学院的详细信息，从哪里去查阅呢？从哪里去查阅？我觉得你应该是想知道我们的那些 research field 对吗
？Yeah.
对，Dr. Nadia, she would like to actually know about some of our research fields.
Yeah.
So she's asking whether do we have any that is involving intercultural communication, cross-cultural communication?
Yes, actually we have a variety of fields that you may apply to because our lecturers have different specialties of a different area of specialty. So if you're talking about intercultural communication, we do have several lecturers who are interested in that area, so you might want to pursue for research by research, because if you're looking into coursework or by mixed mode is also okay. Actually, you might want to just learn about the methods first, and then you might want to pursue your area of interest. Okay, for example, intercultural communication is there, journalism is there, public relations is there, advertising, and also media studies, film and broadcasting, television. So we have a variety of areas, and if you want to know all the areas, you might want to surf our website.
Now, can you give your website, your apartment website on the board?
On the chat.
Or the WeChat, on yeah.
Okay.
是一定要考雅思5分或者怎么样吗？
你是说我们的 English requirement 对吗？
对，yeah.
我们是刚才一样的。 Dr. Dennis is asking about our English requirement. So 刚才我们 maybe you would like to show the 是给哪一个 program 吗？ Sorry.
How again? The English requirement is it?
Yes.
Okay, right.
假如我是就是这个学生，他是英语专业的学生，还需要这个考雅思吗？
英语专业就是他是English 是他的 degree 对吗？
Yeah.
Okay.
Is this for master of our PhD?
请问是 for master 或者是 PhD？
Repeat again. 还是想读博士的。
还是想读博士的。It's for PhD. Dr. Nadia. She's asking if let's say the student has taken an English degree. Would they still require the IELTS?
English degree.
Yeah.
So no. If you studied in English language, I mean, if you're studying the linguistic itself, then you're exempted for the other requirements. But you might you need to give your statement of proof for that particular course you did.
对的，就是补充一下，是他是说，如果是那个medium of instruction， 如果本人是有用英文的话呢，来学习那个 degree， 这样就应该可以有 exemption， 可是如果没有的话，就需要那个 English requirement。
我的意思就是说，假如这个学生他是英语硕士是英语专业的。 然后，对，他就可以不考雅思了，是吗？他的那个硕士是在就是用英文方面吗？是吗？对呀，是啊，就是major is
English 对吗
？English yeah.
对对，这样跟着我们的 requirement 是应该不用的，可是都是你可以 email 我们。
再详细的让我们给我们看一下，这样我们可以确定。因为我们也需要一些证据。另外还我想问一下，就是这几位就是比如文化研究或者传播学的这一块，他们有没有就是导师又懂就是马来语，又懂英语，又会中文的？就说比如可能就是因为 I am a Chinese, I want to find a professor. Understand some Chinese, yeah. Then we can communicate easily.
对的，所以在我们的website呢，我们会有 list of academics， 我们的那一些教授，然后都有好几个都是华人，然后都会比较会华语的，你可以尝试看一下他们的那一些。
那我是在哪里可以要到你们那个就 website
呢？好，我们过会放在这个 group chat
呢。OK，好的 ，Thank you，Thank
you，好，谢谢你。这样还有一个就是，我是在
not full time student 啊 ，I want to part time student，yeah， 这个要求每年在马来会待多长时间这样的？
我们的那个 part-time student 是看作那个 duration， 如果是你是讲那个 doctor 吗？
是 doctor， yeah。
doctor， 他是 part-time 是 minimum 是6个 semester， 然后 maximum 是15个 semester， 就6个 semester 就是说3年呐，这个时间，可是你在马来西亚的那个时间呢，好像刚才那个 Dr. Tay。 稍微刚才讲的，要看一下，就是可能有一些教授会比较严格，是需要你在这里做那一个research， 可能有一些研究，然后可能有一些要看你的研究的那个方式了。OK，thank
you，yeah，thank you。
对，所以有什么疑问，你也可以 email 在这个chat 那边，Hasrina @usm.my 也可以。
I can see your email address. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, okay. So Dr. Nadia, we just need to put in the 你们也可以看到在这一个 slide 里面，你可以看到 communication.usm.my 那一个就是我们的 school website. So for everyone, you can see that communication.usm.my that's for our school website. you can find out our academic staff and also the programs that we offer. Thank you so much. Do you have any other questions?
Excuse me, doctor.
Yes.
Can I speak Chinese?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, okay.
我是大学三年级马来语专业的学生，我想计划明年九月份到想读那些传媒学或者是新闻学方面，我想问我这个专业可不可以申请，还有一些条件，比如说我的绩点是2.7级的样子。
你绩点是2.7级啊？
对。
Sorry， 刚才你是讲你的专业是马来学是吗？
马来语，
马来语，巴哈萨马来语，
巴哈萨马来语，对。然后那个是for你的 degree 是吗？你是说？
我是是大学三年级的学生，然后我想问一下，我这样子肯 master 和master 还有 doctor 估计是申请不了吗？因为我是之前没有接触过传媒学，是想去过去就是类似于coursework 类型的课。
OK， 啊，你稍微等一下，我先问一下我的这个同事啊。
好的，谢谢。
Dr. Nadia。
Yeah.
Yeah. So she's saying that her studies, if I'm not mistaken, was on Bahasa Melayu. But she is interested to pursue a postgraduate in communication. So she's asking whether are there any requirements and so on and so forth.
She learned in Bahasa Melayu?
Her area of study is in Bahasa Melayu actually.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, but I think for to admit to the
Dr. Nadia. Here, Dr. Nadia.
Yeah. Yes.
Her major is in Bahasa Melayu.
Okay.
So she want to study communications. Will your school these applications?
You still need to have the English requirements actually, because the programs are in English.
Mm-hmm. 不好意思，这位小姐，你还需要需要有那个托福跟雅思的成绩。
哦，是考雅思是五点六分。
对，5.0。对，
好的，好的。谢谢您。就是我这个专业，比如说有一些经济，有一些什么会计那些，就可能不能申请。不过我们传媒学，我是马来语本科专业，是可以申请吗？
他们需要考虑，因为要看你的之前有哪部之前的成绩是怎样子，然后你的本科，虽然是你的专业是在马来语，可能你有一些科目，你有哪个别的科目有跟他们有联系的，有关系到的，他们都会考虑。
哦，好的，好的，谢谢您。
好的。还有什么问题吗？
我还提一个吧。比如就是我刚才说我是英语专业的，对吧？
对。
但是我那个研究生的时候没有修这个传播学的，还要重新再修一些专业吗？
你再问再重复你的问题一下。
我的意思就是说比如我是英语专业的，但我也带着传播学的这个研究生。但是我就没有这个证明，是我原来就说是学你们这个硕士的时候是学传播学专业的。
就是说现在你要学传播学对吧？在你的
在 doctor 的时候 ，yeah。
对的 ，doctor 的时候，Doctor Nadia。
Yes。
These students are these potential student asking us whether we consider her。If her master degree is in English, major in English.
Oh, okay.
She want to further study in communications. Is it possible?
Okay. Yes. If the master is in English, then you're exempted from the other English requirements. So, for language, it's actually very related to communication. So, we definitely welcome you to communication.
No, the question is she's from different fields. major in master, but she want to study PhD in communications. Will your school is consider these applications?
Yes, yes.
Okay, 好的，是可以的，你可以申请，我们会考虑。
意思就是说，我是担心，就是说还要不要重新再选？尽管就说我因为我已经是我是老师嘛，其实我也是硕生导师，对吧？我已经带着传播学的研究生了，那我还需要，如果是我读你们的这个博士的话，还需不需要 对读再重修这个传播学的课程？
这一个要看你的你的经
验研究领域或者我一些成果，
对对对，
是吧？
对对对对对，这个是要你的这些资料我们才能够做决定，不好意思。
Okay, thank you. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. Yeah, 还有问题吗？
博士你好，我想问一下，就是我是以前没有接触过传媒学，但是想几乎是从 bachelor 开始学，是这种是可以申请是哪一申请是哪一种是 coursework 吗？还是
您现在有你是在读本科吗？
我是大学三年级的。
你在读本科，只是你没有传媒学，你没有传媒学的背景，只是
是的，是以后想就是基础开始学这个。
Dr. Nadia.
Yeah.
This potential student asking us, whether will we consider her? She doesn't have any communication study, communication background.
Okay.
She didn't study, she not even studied communications before. Her major is in Bahasa Melayu. So, School of Communication consider her applications?
Yes, actually, because we have several areas which the language can be examined in the context of communication. So yes, we do actually consider students with language background.
Okay, good. 是可以的，他们会考虑你的申请，没问题。
谢谢您，教授。
好。Any more questions? 还有别的问题吗？
你好。你好，能听到吗？
听到。
你好，我想问一下，在您这学校，然后那个读博士期间的话，有没有这种双学位，就是联合学位，这些项目？然后在读的期间有没有这个交换的项目？这些？
有的是有这样的一个项目，但是你要看你在哪一个学院读，而你会被接收在那一个项目吗？不是每一个项目都有这样的一个双修的课程。
对，我就是想问一下，咱们传播学院有没有和这个新闻学、传媒这个方面的这方面项目
？OK， Dr. Nadia.
Yes.
This student asking us whether your school has any double degree program.
Double degree,
meaning
for which one?
Meaning that you have any double degree, dual degree?
No. Actually, we don't have any of those yet.
Okay.
For undergraduate, we have history where a student have actually.Conducted double degree for undergraduate, but for postgraduate, we don't offer any yet.
Okay. 不好意思，在研究生课程里面，我们没有这一个课程。
那好的，听到了。好，谢谢。
谢谢你。Any more questions? 还有什么问题吗？
您好。
您好。
如果今年就是一直没有办法参加雅思或者托福考试的话，那怎么办？可以如期入学吗？
我们能够做的就是您先申请，如果你已经符合了其他的条件，只是剩下雅思的方面的话，我们会给你一个有条件式的录取通知书。然后过后你再去考雅思，而且你如果已经过了那个雅思，通过了雅思的考试的话，你可以再来直接来我们大学。
那这个有条件的那个 offer 是有效期多长时间呢？
Barang apa nama validity dia conditioning offer letter. Conditioning offer letter validity dia berapa lama?
Untuk program?
Secara umum.
Conditioning offer letter bergantung kepada validity of the offer letter research setahun. Kalau masuk mismut, ikut structure program
setahun. Ning si yang sengqing naik ke siangmu, naik ke kecena?
Film study.
Film study, communication.
Yeah, yeah.
是研究型的吗？
PhD
是 PhD 啊、
，
一年，
yeah， 对，今年
一年，听到吗？一年里面
哦， oh, 一年，
就是说如果
哦哦、oh,
对，就是说如果我你在八月的时候收到我们的录取通知书，有条件式的录取通知书。就是说在明年八月之前你要能够通过那个雅思的成绩的考试。
如果就是非常非常意外的情况下，就这个疫情一直没有得到缓解，然后雅思考试一直得不到恢复的话，那我们到时候会不会有特殊的政策？
到时候我们会再考虑，因为这一个是我们。到时候是什么事情我们还不能够真正的去猜测到这到时的情况是怎样子，所以暂时回答不到你这个问题。
哦，好，谢谢。
不好意思 ,OK。Sorry everyone, we time's up for school of communication sessions. Thank you, Dr. Nadia.
Thank you, everyone.
Okay. So, if you have any questions, please feel free to email us.Okay, we will answer you accordingly. Okay, 不好意思，我们时间有限，传播学院的讲解会就到此结束，我们会进入另外一个环节，谢谢。